It shows you really love tea. I see from the cups. Mini tea, big tea, mini medium.
And this episode is crazy for real. Bro.
Okay. Are you ready?
Remember. Ready when you
are. Welcome, welcome, welcome back to another special episode of iTalk. As the guests come in one by one, please move closer to the mic, sir. And let's see everyone's situated. Okay. Welcome, welcome, welcome back to another special episode of iTalk. iTalk, which I've heard is a call center name for some scam company also. I've heard that thing as well. But welcome to iTalk, the podcast. I'm your host, Pretty Boy with the three in the building. As per usual, you already know. You see me every day. Practically every day. Technically every day. Metaphorically every day. English. You must learn English. Open your books. Don't sleep on them. You fail. But today in the building, I'm talking a lot for this intro because we've got Rodeo to the World, return guest on the channel. Shout out to Rodeo to the World. Mr. NTFL is coming. NTFL is coming, but NTFL is never here. Yeah. Second guest is Mr. NKOSI. King.
The King.
King Bob. Yeah, shout out. So, Rodeo, let us know who you are, what you do for people who don't know you.
What's up? It's your boy Brandon, Rodeo to the World, and I'm from Naples World. Yeah, I just pulled up again, you know, had to come back because it's lit here in the park, man, you know. iTalk, gotta spill the teas. Shout out, man. Yeah, anyways, make music. Probably you guys seen that previous episode. I was playing some of my shit. But yeah, shout out to that. It's good.
Yeah, as we distract him.
Yeah, anyways, man, yeah, that was that.
Shout out. NKOSI, who are you? What do you do? Let us know. Or what do you want us to know you do?
Okay. I go by the name of NKOSI, and yeah. But I usually call myself Tyler in sake of writing and all that. What I do is I do poetry, I do book writing. And at some point, I do motivational talks. If I'm just in the right position or right moments and emotions, I can try music there and there. But then I'm a person who's always busy. I'm working. I'm always stuffed. Yeah?
English just revealed something to me. Say racing cars.
Racing cars.
Okay. But your R, sometimes it's your R.
Yeah.
But you can R. Now, what's the problem?
I don't know.
Whatever. Or maybe instinctively it's just but when you think about it, you can pronounce the right R.
When somebody asks about it, I can pronounce it. But then whenever I'm talking,
you can't.
Nah.
It slips. Okay, no, that's super dope. So poetry, bro, poetry. Poets are boring.
I'm listening.
So yeah, at least that's what a lot of people would think, you know, that poets are boring.
Yeah.
But essentially poets are like musicians without beats.
100%.
To a certain extent.
100%.
You know? But it depends also on the type of poetry you do, because some people do more like spoken word and doesn't necessarily have to rhyme, like, you know, and it's just about a specific point.
Straight to the point, yeah.
So what kind of comedy?
Poetry
do you do?
Okay, the poetry that I do is not quite complicated. It depends on where I'm at, how I'm feeling. Everything is just driven by emotions. But in the poetry I do, I can do horrific poems, I can do romantic poems, I can do sad poems, depending on how I'm feeling at that moment of time. Yeah. And boring poets I don't know if you've seen them anyway, but then yeah, I think poetry is something that's fun. It depends on how you just walk around it, because it's all about style. It's all about how you're putting things in every perspective that you're doing, on how you actually creative with the style of your writing. But then yeah, it's quite cool.
Yeah. You enjoy it, no?
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Mm. Okay, and then at work, do you tell poems?
It's not everybody that I tell poems to.
Yeah, obviously. But yeah. Like, do you share to like one or two colleagues?
Yeah, I've shared to a few colleagues though, yeah.
Okay, and then what's the general feedback on it?
The general feedback, I'll tell you that, say, you see what you're doing, you know what you're doing for sure. Some would even say, go to the extent of saying that, you know, I've heard people saying they do poetry, but then some of them are claiming, but then I can see from what you've written down that this is something that makes sense, even on the rhymes, on the sensuality of somebody trying to get what everything means on what I've written, the message I can deliver through poetry.
Mm. No, yeah? that's crazy, bro. That's dope. And you talk a lot, bro.
I'm sorry.
No, it's good. You're supposed to talk a lot on the pod.
Yeah, sure.
But that's so dope, bro. That's so dope. And yeah, do you have something you remember, like a poem you could tell us right now and stuff?
I have a lot to remember. I've written a lot of poems, but then I have them on my phone. Yeah. Mm. I can read some.
Read us something.
Yeah, sure. Let me just check it first. Yeah, I've got my phone.
Oh, man, I'm still paranoid, dog.
Paranoid for what,
man? Your dog, bro, and I was coming inside. Damn, bro.
you still tatas early.
But my body's like, cool, man.
Damn, nah. You'll be okay. We only like a couple minutes into the pod. You'll be okay.
Yeah. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to experience that shit anymore, bro, you know?
Yeah.
I gotta make sure that whenever you're pulling up to get us, you make sure that dog is that side, and you make sure that the dog is closed before.
The thing is, people just open for it. That's the thing.
Oh, you feel. Shit.
So even now, you after the pod, we could possibly find it outside. That's the thing. But don't worry. I'll make sure.
yo. Hey, bro, yeah. I literally froze, bro. Like, for a second, no. Yeah.
Yo, bro.
Couldn't run. I couldn't climb the wall.
Nothing, bro.
I couldn't do anything, though.
You're trapped.
I couldn't do anything. But yeah, that was that.
Did you wish you had a bottle of baby oil at that moment?
No, fuck. That's MPTD shit, bro. Fuck. Nah, we ain't with that, bro.
Nah. Crazy with the daily stuff, eh?
That's crazy.
Bro.
Got your point, bro?
I'm still checking.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's still finding the best poem.
P. Diddy, man.
Bro, P. Diddy. You must do a poem on P. Diddy.
Yeah. I might try.
That would be dope.
Shit, man. I'm coming like that, bro. P. Diddy, man. Nah.
Yo, bro. That nigga scandalous. Scandalous. A 1,000 bottles, bro.
Bro, how horny are you, bro?
Bro, 1,000 bottles.
How horny is he, bro? That's great. Oh, and that's just weird, bro.
Like, super.
Like, super. Super. Who buys 1,000 of baby oils, dog? 1,000 bottles. Who buys that, dog?
Shame. All the poor men getting stretched out with those baby oils. Bro, that's fucked up. And all the children in Africa who are ashy as hell, not getting the baby oil as well. It's sad. But yeah, what can you do when a billionaire wants to buy baby oil to stretch out men? Hey, man.
You're killing me, bro. Crazy.
No, it's crazy, bro. It's super crazy. But yeah, no, I can't wait to see how the case will develop. What they're gonna release to the media as well, you know. It's crazy. And no, the realization that I had, right, with this whole Diddy stuff was that, like, if ever you're trending, right, you just have to wait long enough, then you'll stop trending, right? So, yeah, whether it's good or bad, whether people are trashing you online or people are showing you love, you just wait long enough until the next
person gets it. Or the
And then we talk about the next person, you feel?
But so, by this situation, I don't think it's just going to end like that. Even if, no, it's not trending, bro. I don't feel like...
No, yeah. No, it's going to die down a bit, you know. It's going to go a bit low until something big else happens in the case, you know. Because we're getting these things. The last time before this, the last time before he got arrested and all this, the last story was the house getting raided and it.
Yeah.
But before that... In between that, there was like no stories, big major stories major getting stories, covered, yeah. You know. We're probably focused on Kendrick performing at the Super Bowl and
not
whatever.
Like us type shit.
Yeah. Did you see the top five? What happened to the top five and them?
What happened?
Okay, so basically, top five, they like to call him Drake's goon from Toronto. He said he's gonna watch the Not Like Us music video and something about just to see who was in the video and like, yeah,
you're gonna call for them,
something of that sort.
That's crazy.
And then obviously it was just a media stunt, and then yeah, people started responding to it, and then I don't know how Aiden Ross got involved. But yeah, there was a whole thing with Back on Fig. Like, it was a whole controversy with top five involved. But yeah, it's still on the Drake and Kendrick beef, you know? And my thing with it is... Nah, feel free. Feel free.
Hello?
Yeah? Angusa? Okay, so pay it. Okay. I'll send you now. Niti o ngasebenzi Capitec uthe ngeya. Ongizokusendela manje angazi ukuthi uprefer yini.
She's gonna watch the pod.
So ngenze.
She's gonna watch the pod.
Yes, bengicela favor ne. Mfuna ungisendele one of amapoem ungabhalile lapha efonini yakho ngiyawa-checka kuma-file like imawekho. Kwe-straight enambeni yakho, hayi ku-chat yethu. You know when you check on your numbers laphayana. U-check enambeni yakho la ujwayele ukubhala khona kwama-under nani. You'll get it there. Sharp, ngizothenga idatha manje then we'll talk nge-WhatsApp. Ukuthi ngithole i-message yakhona. Wena? Okay, ngizolinda ugesi ubuye-ke. Then ungathenga uyathenga ngi-Capitec. Thenga ngi-Capitec. Okay. Yeah? Say Kelvin. Say Kelvin.
Wait, sir, the Kelvin.
Yeah. Msa no road yola, Brandon.
Shout out, Brendan Rodeo. Shout out, Rodeo to the world.
What things you send? Like, what? You're right. You send. You send. Let's try my number. Can you find a manje? You send. Look, yes, man. You find a manje. My number now, then.
Definitely, should get a shout out.
Definitely, shout out.
Part of the pod.
Chop.
Part of. Okay.
I'm saying she should definitely get a shout out. She's part of the pod.
Yeah, shout out to Miss NKOSI.
Shout out.
Shout out. I hope you are watching this. Obviously you are because he's here. If you are not watching this, then, hold on. If she's not watching this, technically she's not hearing what I'm saying.
Yeah, she is.
So for her to get the judgment, she has to watch it. There's no judgment if you watch it. So it doesn't make sense for me to say all this stuff. You know? Yeah, but shout out to you. Taking a Capitec, no call. You've got no, but yeah, I was just while you were talking, I was just thinking for someone who doesn't understand Zulu but knows Capitec. They just hearing Capitec. Yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy. But shout out, shout out.
It's crazy.
So yeah, we'll be waiting on the poem. Right. But what I was speaking about, back to Kendrick, Drake. So long after the whole rap beef, we are still talking about the beef because there's these little branches of the beef, you see, that are happening. Mm. And yeah, I don't know if this is going to be like a constant cultural war, you know, that it's going to always be this thing, you know.
Drake versus Kendrick.
Yeah, or like, are we going to ever move out of this era, you know? Or is it going to be a thing of, like, is it going to be an AKA Casper thing? Basically, you know, you see how they were, even like they were just not getting along. There's always that thing,
something.
Yeah. Till AKA died, it was still like that, you know. The only thing that ended that beef was AKA's death, basically.
Yeah.
So is it gonna be like that sort of thing? I mean,
we don't know, bro.
Yeah, we'll see. But personally, if a nigga made a hit song calling me some nasty stuff and all that, yo, bro, I don't know. If I'm Drake, I don't know, bro. I don't know if I can forgive you that easily, bro.
Freaky ass nigga, he is 69.
Bro, OVO, all these things, bro. I know. I bro. Freaky I'm, ass I'm not nigga. Jesus, man. There's a level you can take it. But, hey, man. Hey, just imagine. Just too much. Bro, the problem is it's a hit song. That's the problem. So you go on your TikTok, you hear it. This, you hear it. You see, so it's like, bro, it's everywhere, bro. You're gonna get sick and tired of it, you know.
And imagine you're that big as Drake, dog.
Bro, you feel. And yeah, but no, the bigger question comes to Kendrick, because Kendrick did drop after Not Like Us, but that drop didn't get eyes on it, right? No one even knows. Did you even hear that Kendrick dropped after Not Like Us?
No.
Nah.
Yeah. So it was just a testament that, is Kendrick really popping though, if we get to it? Or did the beef with Drake make Kendrick really popping?
Kendrick, bro, if you're watching this, bro. I don't know, bro.
No, I mean, it is what it is. It is what it is. It's a thing, you know. Yeah. If you look at the stats, you look at the why didn't his next song become the only reason Not Like Us popped was because of the storyline. You know, we're all following along. Even I was on Kendrick's side for Not Like Us, but I didn't go listen to that song he dropped after Not Like Us. Why?
Why is that?
Why didn't you go listen? Because Mina is a hip hop fan. How do I benefit with Kendrick's song after Not Like Us? Like, what is in it for me? What entertainment value is in it for me? What is Kendrick gonna talk about on the... I don't even know what he's talking about. But Kendrick's content is different, you know. My favorite last Kendrick album was Damn, which was like 2017, right? After that, his content has been super different, you know, and it's not for me, you know. So I assumed Velo Uti, the most recent one, is probably back to his old thing, because people weren't talking about it. Why? We wanted to hear Kendrick bring out more of that LA sound. You feel? Kendrick on that LA sound, bro, that mustard beat, dog. Mm. It's some other stuff, bro. It's bringing back the YG era for me. Like, that's West Coast music. I got like super introduced to it via YG, you feel, West Coast music. Yeah, it's giving that a lot, you feel. So yeah, with him not being able to capitalize off Not Like Us for his next record is just, yeah, it's a bit weird, you know. It's a bit weird. And on the flip side, Drake released this song No Face No Case with Cardi. Was it with Cardi? Yeah. Even though Cardi wasn't even on the song, I saw comments complaining which he was 20 seconds in the song or something.
Yeah.
But that song did pretty well, you know. I heard about it, you know. Yeah. So it's like, yeah, man, you gotta really question. And it's like, it's going back to how it used to be before the beef, right? Because before the beef, this is how it was. Jake was Drake more popping top, than Kendrick. Yeah. You feel? Yeah. And Jake, it's like the beef, as much as it, I feel like the beef didn't flip the whole thing around. It just separated who's who, you know, who's riding for who, who's on which side, you know. And yeah, it's super, super interesting to see. Super interesting. And yeah, but the niggas sold records and we're about to get into the poem, right?
Yeah, 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 correct, correct. Okay, I finally found out.
Yeah. Let's hear some poetry.
Oh, so yeah. This is the first poem I ever wrote.
Really?
Yeah, yeah, sure. I was still in high school.
Okay, okay.
So it was talking about emotions and feelings. I'll just read it, as I've written it.
Yeah.
You touched my emotions, so thrilling without even using your hands. With your well-spoken words, you swiftly pierced my heart. You made it feel like a bed, where you only can lie till the end.
Mm.
Emotions and feelings. You touched my emotions. Without hands, you still did it. You touched them so sweet, though it wasn't like honey, it was better than money. You made me realize how sweet, sweet things are. Even with your lips, you confirmed it. If love was pain, I still wouldn't hesitate loving you. You made me realize why my heart kept on pumping even when I'm sleeping. Emotions and feelings. You touched my emotions. Without fingers, all part of my heart felt it. Without my permission, you did it intentionally. Regardless of any feelings, you went precise and touched me emotionally. Besides any meaning, you got me flattered sarcastically. Without any need of expression, you proved it physically. Without an explanation and meditation, it was so noticeable. I know with love on my hand, I'll touch you till the end. Yeah. Thank you.
So that was dope.
That was dope, man.
That was my first poem.
Sounded like for a script,
first,
bro.
Yeah. Bro, for his first poem.
Yeah. I have a lot. These are documents of my poems.
Damn, bro. That's definitely a lot. So publishing them, like what...
You know, when I was growing up, I thought actually the environment I'm within, because I didn't understand media that much. So I thought the environment that I grew up in didn't have people that was so into reading. So I thought, okay, sharp, I can only write them but not publish them.
Mm.
Probably when I change environment where I can get to be with people that like reading, maybe I can.
You can publish.
Because I didn't understand media then.
Mm.
Yeah, I thought it was not so easy. I thought it was like writing on a paper and just selling with papers.
Yeah.
But then now I understand that things sell with media. You can do anything with media without you being in contact with people, without you writing it down. You can literally do hard copies,
yeah,
but then still you can sell with media.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm.
That's why I didn't publish.
Mm.
Sure.
Crazy. But would you visualize it? Like if I said, we take your poem, right? You do a voiceover, like you speak it, whatever.
Sure.
Then you come up with a script, like while you're speaking, like the concept of what you're speaking about, we get like actors or people to act it out and like,
that's what I was thinking.
Make
it
visual.
Sound like a movie, like be something like a movie type shit.
Yeah, but like, because poems are like not more than 2 minutes. It could be like a scene. You
it
feel
could be a scene for sure.
That that would be crazy, bro. That would be crazy
for sure.
But yeah, you should look into that, bro. Look into that, like how you could make it more content. Like you feel, because also, it's like if you're just gonna write the poetry for you, God never gives you a talent for you.
Yeah,
someone out there needs to understand, which is someone can touch their heart like they touched it with their hands.
I feel you, man. Someone out there needs to hear the message.
You feel so, yeah, somewhere, somehow, yeah. But yeah, bro, for your first poem, that's incredible.
That was years big,
bro. That's incredible. That's why I'm saying for your first poem, so I know that there's a lot of growth that you've had, a lot of things you've fixed.
Sure.
And yeah, it's crazy, bro. No, it's crazy.
Sure. Thanks, man.
Damn.
Shout out, bro.
Thanks. Shout out, Nkosi. Shout out, King.
Yeah.
Nah, shout out, bro. But, Rodio.
Like, why are you coming at me, bro?
Nah, bro, you it's your second time back. You've been super quiet. We need to hear what's happening.
I'm not quiet, bro. I'm just smiling and waving to the camera, bro.
Yeah, no. Kissing babies and what did he say? Hugging people, kissing babies.
I don't know about that.
No deity.
No deity.
But what did they call it? Shaking hands and kissing babies. I think that's what it is. It's like when politicians go out to campaign. Then yeah. They're like, yeah, he was out there shaking hands and kissing
babies. Trump. Trump,
definitely. But it's Trump, man. Trump still has a possibility to win. Who do y'all think is winning? Trump. Hillary Clinton.
Trump.
I said Hillary Clinton. Kamala Harris. Kamala Harris or Donald Trump?
Trump. Donald Trump for me, yeah.
Maybe, yeah. I mean, but it's like the Democrats. I feel like if Kamala wins, it will be what happens with ANC, where they don't necessarily like the representative, but they go with the party. So ultimately,
let me tell you what I say. Sorry
for Trump. Coming. Yeah.
Let me tell you what I say, Trump, bro. Yeah. After that stunt, the fact that they're trying to shoot him. The assassination, whole
bro,
shit.
Bro, they tried again at the golf course after the year one. They tried again at the golf course.
He survived twice.
Bro.
That nigga, dog, he has to be president, dog. Everybody's voting for
him. He has to be, dog. He has to be. No, why are they trying to knock him off is the question. You feel?
Have you watched The Simpsons?
Yeah, I've watched, which... Simpsons predictions.
So there's this other episode I've seen. I thought it was AI made, but it wasn't. It was made like way before these AI shit. So like, there's a part where they're showing Trump like ruling. He did rule before, like he was a previous president. But now he has to fuck up the economy. That's the only thing that's left in America, like the economy to get fucked up. After that, Hillary, what's her name?
Kamala.
Sorry.
Not Kamala. I said Kamala. It's Kamala. Just Kamala.
Kamala. Yeah, Kamala-ish. Her time is gonna come. It's definitely not this year though.
Calamari. Is calamari Indian?
I think so.
Cause Kamala and calamari has a, similarities. And she is Indian.
What? Kalahari, Kamala, crazy.
Calamari.
Calamari, yeah.
It's Kalahari. Are you talking about a desert, man?
No, isn't that Sahara?
Is it Kalahari?
Is the
desert called Kalahari? Kalahari. Sounds like it has to be
Sahara Desert.
Sahara Desert, yes.
Sounds like a dish.
Sahara.
Kalahari.
Sahara could definitely be a dish.
Not Sahara, Kalahari.
Kalahari.
Yeah.
Yeah, Kalahari.
Like a spicy.
Okay. Indian. Kalahari.
Kalahari.
Kala.
It sounds like a hot dish.
Yeah.
A hot dish.
Sounds like a fast food restaurant.
Fast food.
Kalahari. Kalahari. Yo, hey, are you ever caught in traffic? You can come through and Kala will hurry. Kala hurry. Then they only get people named Kala to work there.
Hey, Kala, Kala.
Yeah, so you'd have to change your name in your ID if you want to work
to Kala.
There. Yeah, but I would do it if they pay Big Bang.
That's crazy.
Yeah, I'd be Kala for 10 years or whatever, however long you work there. Then you can change back to your name. That would be dope.
That's crazy.
But imagine you can change your name, but I wonder if you can change your name again, or do you get one chance?
You can change your name as many times as you can. Just don't do illegal shit.
For sure. It happened. I'm not so sure that it happened.
Yeah.
But then I was still young. I think there was an incident where somebody was facing charges in the court. So what happened is that he added 25 more names to his ID so that he could just trick the judge to call all his names before starting to talk about his case. You know? Ooh. So yeah, I'm thinking you can actually change them anyhow and you can have as many names as you want.
Yeah, I think so too.
That must have been some serial type of
guy,
if he was like a drug trafficker, serial something, for them to have all like your identities, it's like, that's crazy. But it's crazy. But the government, what do you think? Do you think Mzansi would be dope if we had like a FBI type of system, or the corruption is just over.
Honestly, bro, I feel like we do, just that we don't know about these things, you know, like sometimes they never really publish, like the real face, the people that are like behind closed center, because they know that people are going to know about it, type shit, so...
I could be a fed right now. We wouldn't know.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, that's true. That's
what you want.
Yeah.
Man, I'll call you niggas up for sure.
That's crazy. That's crazy, man. But yeah, that's that, bro.
Yeah.
You never really know, bro.
It might happen. Days, maybe. But then these things are called different in different countries.
Yeah.
So it's FBI there.
And CIA.
Somewhere CIA, somewhere SWAT.
It's called different things.
At most, we know American things because we always watch their movies.
Yeah, and it's shown in their movies.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. But then we have G4S is corps. Is it corps or what? But
G4S is private security.
Yeah, sure. We do have that.
We definitely have a lot of private security. And I feel like the best guys, if you're going to hire private security, the best guys to hire are the guys who protect taxi bosses. If you want to hire private. Because those niggas see it all. Them niggas, they see it all, bro. They probably, the taxi industry is probably the most violent industry in SA.
For sure.
Just from its smaller scale to even larger, you know.
Yeah.
It's like, it's crazy.
It is. You can say.
You know, there was a you guys know Cut Blanche, right?
Cut Blanche.
Cut Blanche. It plays on Mnet. It's like this South African news thing. It's like more professional. You know, it's not your SABC style. You know, they once had what's the white guy? They had this white guy was something what? I think yeah. But, and they have this other Indian lady, but they have these people. I think she was from Checkpoint once upon a time. I'm not too sure. But either way, Cut Blanche is basically, they document like South Africa. It's like Boma, what's that show I just mentioned now?
Checkpoint
type of thing, you see. They'll it's like an expose type of show, yeah.
Oh, sure.
So they were showing the life of like a taxi boss and... His kids have to go to school like with bodyguards, literally. Like his kids. And I was just thinking about that life, that as a kid, you'd probably want that. Because as a kid, you can't tell me you're a kid who never imagined yourself with rich parents, how you'd be.
It's obvious.
You know, if you're
all of that fantasy, you know, bro. If that guy was my father,
you know,
I think it was his mom, yeah, for sure.
Exactly.
If the guy was my father, but some things would be different. Yeah, sure.
The cost of that, you know, the cost of that is scary because it's gonna be like, I fear like a child star. You see how child stars become?
Sure.
And like the Michael Jackson effect of you've been famous since you're a kid. Your childhood is never normal.
The fact that, you don't have freedom.
You know, that freedom is like, you're always with a bodyguard. Like, normal kids things, like, you get a girlfriend, y'all go to the movies, whatever. Your bodyguard is there with y'all. You know, it's like certain things we don't look at, but they just condition.
Sure.
You know, people, they just condition people. And it's just, it's scary. And I just wanted to bring it to the point of like, how much should you think about how your career impacts your kids?
How much
of that, like, should you consider that a lot, especially since they're not here yet, right?
Sure.
I hope you're gonna have kids.
I was just thinking about it.
Don't say I never asked them when a kid pops up in 2 years. But like how much thought should go behind that, like your career choice in terms of your kids, you know,
and
versus the money as well, because you're also trying to have the money, you're also trying to have
future for your kids.
I never really thought about it like that, bro. Like imagine your kid is like growing up to like where like they have everything. Sometimes like they don't understand like where things like come from you get, yeah, yeah, and they don't appreciate that because they never really lacked anything, you know what I'm saying? I never really like thought about it like that. Also with that security shit I just said right now. Ish, my kids, you guys gotta have security, but hey, they're gonna stay far a bit, yeah.
Yeah, no, but yeah, we should yeah, but it's crazy, bro, because think about it, when as a rapper, one day you're Drake status, your son is born into this fame that he didn't ask for, and that he doesn't have the option to have a normal childhood like you, you know? So why aren't you considering that? You know,
I'm saying I never really thought about it like that.
You should think about it. We should definitely consider these things, you know. It
should be considered for sure.
At the end of the day, it's like it's your responsibility to make sure which your child becomes a functional adult in society, right? Because that's your child, young toddler. So if you're gonna change their childhood, and then next thing they are doing Jeffrey Epstein stuff when they are older, and you don't understand, but they just never had a childhood.
That's normal, that was normal,
you feel?
Yeah, sure.
And yeah, it's crazy because those formative years, they build who you are, you know, they build a lot of how you see the world, this and that, you know, which is very important. They don't get entitled, you know.
Sure.
And I believe, Mina, if like, you know, when that time comes, I'm rich, not my kids. Yeah, for sure. Them niggas will get the basic needs, whatever. But I just wish that my kids have the same drive as me so that I don't have to necessarily force them and take extra measures. They must also want to be great in their own way. And once you get that, then it's super perfect. Even if your kid is like, my kid is like to me, I want to be the best sports car driver in the world. I'd be so happy because they're passionate and
they want to do something. They
want to do something, you feel? They're not just comfortable in, you know, where they are, because then I would have to take the measures to be like, okay, since you are too comfortable, we're cutting this, you feel?
Yeah,
because, also, you, if you had everything, you'd be super spoiled, you'd be a snob. I wouldn't be talking to you right now, right?
Most probably.
Bro, like, no one likes a snob. That's the problem. Yeah, even probably. from a young age, like no one. When I used to be a kid, right?
It happens.
But yeah, back then there was a kid called Joseph, right?
Yeah.
He used to live here, yeah, and I think he still lives here, but he's a lot older now, whatever. But I remember this one moment, my brother and I were visiting him at his house, and he was a snob. That kid was a snob. Like, his parents got him everything for sure. Like, he got a bicycle, he had these toy Ferrari cars, right? And he wouldn't let me play with them. I was there, he invited my brother, so my brother brought me as well. Yeah. So he's like, no, you are not gonna play with the toys, your brother can play with it. My brother literally whooped his ass that same day.
That's sick.
Yeah, because no one likes a snob.
Nobody does. Yeah,
no one likes a snob. Even from a young age, we all know, when you're a snob, you just get outcasted, you know, because we don't want Lumtana law when you are losing the game, manju tati pola ngobi pole lako.
Sure,
that's
terrible.
You feel?
That's terrible.
Yeah, beautiful. Now you're ruining the fun for everyone else just because it's your shit.
Yeah.
And if it happens that you grow up with that mentality, with that personality, for sure you'll never be liked your whole life, bruv, because you won't change it.
And that's the thing, your network is your net worth at the end of the day, you know. It's like you can be as rich as you can, but money goes, goes. One day you're gonna need that one person who's gonna be there, and trust me, they will remember when you were a snob to them.
True.
You know, look at me, I'm remembering childhood things, because that was, anytime I hear Joseph or whatever, that's my only memory of him.
You feel? Snobby.
Is the snob guy who didn't want to let me play with his Ferrari cars.
Just imagine your whole life traveling.
That's crazy. Bro,
yeah, but yeah, no. Snobs, guys, snobs. Hey, it's so bad. It's so bad.
It's crazy.
But then, you know, sometimes there are downsides and upsides.
Yeah.
You know, I can hear you saying that if it happens that your time reaches that your child will be, you will be the one who's rich, not your child, right?
Yeah.
But then at some point, bruv, whenever you're rich, you have so many eyes on you, right? Then at some point, these people do it for security. They don't do it just to spoil kids or get, I'm taking my kid to school with the bodyguards. It's all security because sometimes at some point people want to just mess up with you, and at some point if they can't get you, kids. They'll get you with your kids and all that.
That's true.
So yeah, it all comes with money, and it all comes with fame too.
With fame.
Yeah,
with
and whatever. Fame. I think at some point, whatever you wanna do, whatever you wanna teach your kids, however you wanna teach your kids, what you wanna teach your kids, you can just put lessons in the house. You might be rich as you're saying that you are the one who's rich. They are not. They are not. You can tell them in the house that okay, sure. You're not rich. I am the one. This is how it happens. This is how I'm teaching you how to make your own
thing. How to be rich yourself.
Yeah, sure. This is how I'm teaching you how to be your own thing, right? And there are some people who believe in generational wealth. You understand?
I was about to say that.
Yeah, sure.
Like, yeah.
Believing in that.
There's a thing they say the first generation starts it. The second generation enlarges it. Then the third generation destroys it.
Yeah, sure. There is. Yeah.
So you just... It's difficult now because now you must instill your values so much to your kid that you make sure he instills them to your grandchild.
It happens.
Bro.
The cycle is you just
keep on going.
Maybe shadow secluding them. That's why rich people most of the times are secluded to their, like they are sheltered to a certain extent, you know. It's like once you don't get exposed to this, then you won't know about this and ruin this.
Yeah, sure.
You know, it's like rich people won't send their kids to a public school because in a public school, they get to smoke. They get to get into all these bad things.
Yeah,
they
discipline is less.
You feel? Yeah, sure. So it's like you could learn those things and squander the family well.
You're right. Yeah, you know? You're very right. And at some point, some things you're not exposed to again, into your safety, because you can't do something you don't know, for sure. You can't ruin something with something that you know that's been building everything, unless you get, I think, at least new information that's not aligned to the purpose of the family, the purpose of the family moving on, actually. That's what I'm thinking, for sure.
Yeah, no. But, Rodio, you want to
say? Nah, I'm thinking about something. I was thinking about Mboro when I was talking about this whole security shit.
Mboro
kidnapped his children, dog.
They kidnapped or he himself?
He kidnapped his own children.
I didn't hear much about that whole... I didn't understand what's happening there. And, man, Mboro is an entertainer to me, man. He's an entertainer and, he just... God gives him a few words here and there, you know, and but man, the nigga was talking about how he was like, Bushiri fakes, he showed me how to fake these stunts, and Bushiri this, and Bushiri, bro, it's like, I say, Rodio was showing me how to cook drugs, how to sell drugs, how to package drugs, but I never did nothing.
That's crazy. That's fucking crazy.
You see, it makes no sense.
It doesn't make any sense. When at some point I thought he was losing his mind. Whenever that video came out, Slice. Yeah, I was like, hey, this guy, knowing from being a pastor, now he's carrying 5 pounds. He's trying to slice some people.
The guns.
Yeah.
That's crazy, bro. Yeah. This is just crazy.
I thought he was for sure losing his head.
I have a question. Who's going to Chris Brown's concert?
I'm not.
I'm also not.
I don't do concerts in general, but isn't it 700 for the lowest ticket?
What?
I think, yeah. It was
3,500.
3.5.
The lowest ticket.
Early bird. Do I have this shit
lowest
on my phone?
Ticket.
Early bird, bro.
3,500.
The cheapest.
Luckily, Miss Sean doesn't go out like that and do that, but gents, you better hope Chris Brown doesn't get a hold of your girls for the photo shoots. Chris Brown's been going viral with their photo shoots with people's girls.
Hey, boy.
Yeah, y'all niggas better make sure with your girls when they go there, you go with them. 6K.
They're gonna take us there.
No, it's crazy, bro.
This is so crazy.
It's
The prices is just way heavy.
No.
And probably to him is like $150.
Yeah, sure, it's just $150.
Bro, this is insane, bro.
It's just two papers.
Someone's whole salary here,
bro. Yeah, at some point. It's someone's rent.
Bro, you can pay rent, bro.
Yeah, sure.
Just tell me for that's what I'm paying.
And it's some
one
point,
night.
It's some you pay. No, I'm not discrediting people from going to see Chris Brown for sure. But then he's a big guy. 100%. Then
I no, I mean I discredit you for spending that 3.4 just to see Chris Brown. I discredit you. You know what you can do? Take that 3.4. If let's say the three of us are planning on going to see Chris Brown, say I'm going to sell the 3.4. How much alcohol, whatever, if you guys drink, if you guys smoke, hubbly, whatever. We can watch Chris Brown music videos all night on YouTube. We can buy data on top of it and stream it on the TV. Bro,
that's so true. And see him closer.
And see him closer, bro.
The people that are paying 3.5, they're not even seeing him, bro.
Bro. But, hey, man. I judge you. I judge you. Unless if, you know, you've been a dedicated Chris Brown fan. And, like, you know, there's some people, like, that if they ever land, even I have my people, that if they ever land in the country, I definitely have to make a way by fire, by force to see them in person, you know?
Yeah.
But it's a handful of people because, I mean, in general, I don't like a lot of people like that, you know? But Chris Brown is definitely not on that list. I'm sorry. Chris Brown is very musically talented and dancically talented.
He's dope.
He'd be good in Amapiano, you know, Aboma Jaivane, you know. He has that pantula in him. Yeah, he would be a pantula if he grew up this side, for sure. If Chris Brown was unsuccessful, he would have been dancing with the crate at the robot. Trust me. He's got it in him. But shout out to Chris Brown for making a bag out of South Africans.
Shout out, Chris Brown.
Shout out.
Yeah, no. And dude, speaking of Chris Brown, Busta, you also saw Busta Rhymes in SA as well.
Yeah, I was feeling it.
He's doing a lot, but
he had some good time.
Yeah, man, Busta Rhymes, bro. The only Busta Rhymes songs. And I got a blah 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 blah. That's the only Busta Rhymes song I know. So my value. it's a feature. But yeah, so my value for Busta Rhymes. Yeah, he's not there. I don't believe he's one of. Plus, Busta, man, it's like Eminem trying to do Amapiano. It's not the right person, man.
Yeah, it doesn't.
It's not the right.
Doesn't see in the
Amapiano. Amapiano is not for lyrical, super lyrical, miracle people. You feel? Amapiano wants Lil Pump. It needs Lil Pump. You know.
Yeah.
Amapiano needs Lil Pump. Those simple lyrics, you know, and then he comes. He learns some Zulu. He shares drunk flows. He shares his Zulu with the American accent. We'll vibe to it. Trust. Because we'll know Uguti, you went to the Lokshin to learn the language, you feel. And try say it on a song. And we'll get it, you feel. And it needs people, simple people. But I was thinking like more musical artists like your Rihanna. You know, those.
Yeah, Rihanna would vibe with it.
Rihanna.
It would depend on also the producer.
Rihanna and Kabza.
Yeah, Rihanna and Kabza. Kabza would
Rihanna
just do
and
good,
Kabza.
Yeah.
Like, oh, yeah, far, no, yeah. I'm getting. Just gonna stand and hear me high. you see that type of vibe. Yeah, minus the Eminem verse, obviously. But just the chorus type of vibe, I feel like they could cook something of that crazy, sort, you know? Yeah. And yeah, no, it would go crazy, bro. It would go crazy. And like, yeah, man, it's just once you get exposure as SA, like to a bigger, like, you know, once we reach Afrobeats level, once Amapiano reaches Afrobeat level, it will be super beneficial, even to the SA hip hop cats, trust me. To musical, SA musical artists as a whole, it will be more. Why? Because we have intergenre collabs, right? As South African music, right?
Yeah.
So once they see, let's say they go on piano track, right? The CEO, Sizwe Alakain, who used to be Reason, right? And it's like the genres, they mix somewhere, because when you go down the line, you're gonna see all these people he's featured, you're gonna see all these things, and you're gonna tap into newer artists, right? Mm. And the nice thing about people who are musically talented and like with an ear for music is that they could hear something on a hip-hop beat, someone on a hip-hop beat, and imagine them on something else, and it actually becomes a hit, right? So you don't necessarily have to get your sample of artists from Amapiano, but you can broaden it, you know. You can hear someone Likompo, that's the
Skotompo,
Limpopo. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's their genre. Yeah, so you could hear that artist, you know, and then feel which, you know, this artist would be dope on this type of, you know.
Yeah.
And yeah, we just need international recognition. That's what. And Tyler so far is pushing it, you know. Yeah, it's just, yeah, man, it's just, yeah. We need more, you know. I'm super happy though that we are getting so much representation from a female artist, you know. Just firstly to show how beautiful, of course, the women are, you know. And yeah, to show ukuthi we are a progressive country. Yangithola, when it comes to rights, for sure, we are super progressive. Sometimes even way more progressive than I'd like us to be, you know. But yeah, no, it's super dope, bro. It's super dope representing on the highest level. Tyler was it. She won an Afrobeat something award. It's just like there's more genres in Africa, you know, than Afrobeats, you know.
Yeah.
And that message was super important, you know. Super, super important, because a lot of people don't, you know. They don't understand, you know. But, yeah, Tyler, shout out to you. But I think there's two people who are on Tyler's, not to the English, like your heels, yeah, who are on Tyler's heels from SA Hip Hop. Well, there's two. Somnyama, number one, on a global scale. Somnyama, Maclera Doughboy. Those two artists right now, I feel like they've got the potential to reach Tyler level. Right now, in this current state we're in, right? Because, yeah, no, Maclera, bro. Oof. Maclera. Hey, Maclera, man, Maclera. Shout out to Maclera, bro.
Shout out to Maclera.
But, yeah, bro, he's super, super talented. Super talented. I'm thinking now my mind is running wild, because now I'm thinking of Usimamane. Now I'm thinking of K.O. K.O. bro has been on a crazy round, bro. K.O.
K.O. has been at it.
Yeah, K.O.'s been.
Bro, K.O. doesn't get his appreciation, you know.
He's been on the run, yo. He's been.
Bro, like decades.
Yeah, from now, when it was cash time.
Cash time, yeah.
Bro.
It was cash time. Since then, it was cash time. until the crew. No. Was there a crew before cash time? Lebo TKS, man.
TKS, wasn't it the same?
Wasn't
TKS the same?
It was about TKS. No,
it was. They definitely had something.
Yeah, they definitely had something before.
Wasn't Slicker on Lives like the ops with them niggas? Let me check. Tear Gas are one of South Africa's biggest hip-hop crossover successes of the 2000s. The group was formed in 2004 by Ntokozo, K.O., and brothers Ma'i and Dugza.
Yeah, Ma'i is a creative vibe as well.
It and then let me search cash time. Yo, Ma'i, bro. So, Jive, again,
Kuko. Yo, bro, it was good on those days, bro. Yo. It was fire.
Let me search cash time.
Cash time live.
Cash time live members, ne?
Yeah.
Members.
No, some snacks.
Okay, yeah, their roster was K.O., Ma'i, Mugs, AB Crazy, Ntokozo, Zinga, Muzli, and
become extended now. Yeah.
Yeah, whatever it is. But yeah, then Scandal World now. That's the new, you know,
era. Scandal Republic. Yeah, Scandal World. Yes.
Scandal World. Yeah. My favorite. I don't know if Loki is still signed to Scandal World.
Who?
Loki. Super dope artist. Logishi. Full name is Logishi. But because it's short, it's like Loki from Thor. Thor's brother.
Loki.
But he says Logishi. My favorite song was the Showdown. Was it Showdown? I want to pelele, Showdown Army, mangi to pelele, with Blackie here. Yo, bro, it was giving sete. It was like sete
vibes. Yeah.
Yeah, man, I loved that song, bro. Like, Blackie's verse, man, spoke a lot to me. Hold on, I have to. Let me say Showdown Army, cause Blackie. One thing I liked about it, man, Blackie's verse gave me goosebumps when I thought about it. I think it was no, turn it off. They're gonna copyright.
Oh shit.
Them niggas are gonna copyright. Yeah. I don't know who but hold on, let me skip to play. Okay.
Like if I'm an animal.
Drop a hit, go number one, highest funny. Oh, okay, wait. He said, damn it. Now when I'm reading lyrics in Zulu, guys. Hey, I drop a head, go number one, it's fun. Bro, now I have to play it. Please turn on the speaker. It's fine. I'd have to edit. Will I edit it? Should I edit it? Or should I speak over it? I'm probably gonna speak over it. I'm probably gonna... Editing, guys, is too much work for me. You have to forgive me. Okay, camera is gonna cut soon. Very soon. There we go.
Probably chasing an hour now.
Yeah, no, we just crossed over an hour. No. We are crossing over an hour as we speak right now. But... Yeah, it goes on. Until we are tired. Or the sun goes down, whichever comes before.
Sure.
I'm just going to play Blackie's verse, right?
Sure.
It gave me... What? It's on 910,000 views right now.
Is it a music video?
Yeah. 90,000 away from a million.
How many days was dropped?
910,000.
Oh, no, it's 2 years ago. 2 years ago. Oh. 910,000.
Yeah, that's great. That's massive.
Bro, it's massive. Please pass me the speaker, actually.
When, I have to raise it. It's a song 2 years... that was... Yeah, 2 years ago.
2 years ago, yeah. Do you all want to see the music video?
It's not the first time me hearing this song.
For real?
It's not the first time. Man.
It's a dopest track, man. Dopest track. Shout out. Goes crazy.
7K subscribe.
Nangu Logish. That's Loki. Logish. Shout out to you, Loki. Logish.
From Skanda?
Yeah. I don't know if he's still signed, but he used to be at the time. Yeah. But shout out to Loki. Shout out to Logish. I have to speak over the song now because, yeah, you know. You all listen to the song. I'm just speaking. So the audio, they hear my voice as well as this place, you know, so that they can capture the copyright. Yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. But it's crazy. Yeah, but I'll tune for Blackie's verse because that's what we're playing this for. Blackie's verse. Shout out to Somnyama. Pelele, pelele. Ay! Showdown Army. Dopest song. dopest song, though.
It's nice. It hits. I didn't know this song.
Yeah, man, you learn something every day.
Yeah, right.
The easy verse, yeah, I can find it. It's super, man. It's like, it opens your eyes to like, when you get success, young Tola, like that feeling, young Tola, when you're there, fun. But yeah. Sigazonge no somnyama. Yena yeto. Let's go. Shut down now. I'll travel here go number one. Yeah, that's pelele pelele. Yeah, so yes, that's
the song is fire, bro.
Laid back, but sure. Yeah, Blackie's verse definitely had spiritual touch in it. To speak about getting success, bro, as a person who's hustling to do something, bro, it's like you imagine yourself when you reach there, and that's where it put me, bro, when he's speaking. Yo, bro, it's crazy, bro. It's crazy. It's just, yeah, no, bro. And the melodies, bro, like how, like, he's singing. Bro, Blackie's a goat, y'all. Blackie's a goat. The problem is, man, a lot of people, a lot of niggas will like Blackie's rapping stuff, you know? And I just want to show people over to just not the rapping stuff goes hard, you know? He also has some bangers. I'm going to play one of my favorite songs from his recent EP, right?
You really
and
wanna
it's
get
not,
that
it's not, it's not, it's not hip-hop. Like it is hip-hop, but it's not rapidy rap, right? But I just want to show y'all, this nigga is musical, bro. This nigga is multiverse. But this is the song, Davadil.
Oh, you really want the copyright, man?
It's fine, this one can get the copyright. This one is dope, though.
This is an official music video.
No, it's like a visualizer, yeah. Oh.
Let your ass will stick to me, give you everything that you
can. It's lifestyle, bro.
Now, baby girl, make it time for me. Give me love, give me charm. You know, never, gonna worry about me.
Robot boy.
Show you charm. Now, girl, make it time for me. Give me love, give me charm.
Yeah, visualize him.
You know, you don't worry about me.
No.
Yeah. Shout out to Blackie.
Shout out,
bro.
Should call him to the pod, bro.
Bro, he's gotta pull through to the pod. Yeah. Like, one day. Trust. Yeah.
It looks like a lit music video, boy, yo.
Bro, Blackie is a goat, bro. Blackie is a goat, y'all. Blackie is a goat, you know. Blackie is a goat, but I mean, I feel like this video is already clipped. They've hit me with the copyright, so I might as well continue. Now I'm not gonna play. I'm not gonna play Blackie, but shout out to Blackie, right? One of the best we've got in SA. Now my thing is 031 niggas, bro. 031 niggas hold up SA hip hop. Single-handedly, you can remove Pitori niggas, you can remove all these other niggas and just leave 031 niggas. They're gonna hold up hip hop. Next, Nasty C. He has a song with this other dope ass female artist called K-Kid, right? I heard of K-Kid a while back. She was one of the lyricist ones, right? So I just wanna play it for y'all. Nasty C.
I think I've seen the shit that you posted on your status.
That one, bro. It's super dope, bro. It's super dope. Yeah.
K-Kid is from 031 also.
No, I think she's a
Joburg.
She's Khoisa, so she might be Eastern Cape. She might be Eastern Cape, if not Cape Town. Oh, Western Cape. If not Jersey. Oh. Yeah, she's a stud, as you can see. The beat, bro. But Nasty Slick.
I know Nasty.
Nasty.
Because this type shit is his comfort zone, in terms of Nasty.
Bro. Her love me.
Yo.
It gotta be.
Oh, this is crazy.
Bro. It's fire, right? This the year, it gotta be.
I don't know. Second verse, I feel like she took Cash CPT's flow. I'm just saying. Maybe. Second verse, I had a Cash CPT flow. Shout out to Cash CPT. Speaking of Cash CPT, yeah, the song is over. Thoughts, yeah.
I like this song.
It's dope.
The song is not.
This song is not.
Yeah,
even the video
2024.
Yeah.
Year 24.
It's dope. Nasty C's flow, bruh.
Nasty, bro.
Smooth.
Nasty, super smooth.
Bruh.
Super smooth. But while we're on that, SA Hip Hop. I was talking about how K-Kid's second verse sounded like Cash CPT, right? Mm. There's this guy called Ziggy4X. Have you all heard of him?
Ziggy.
You all know Maclera, right?
Yeah.
Maclera has a song with this nigga, right? I'll play you the song. My problem with Ziggy is he raps in Afrikaans.
So, I know the song you're talking about. There's yeah. sort of video. It's this colored boy.
Oh, when they exchange verses yeah. like simultaneously. Yes. Oh, I know that song
yes.
too.
Yes, so.
I know that song.
Ziggy, do you all, are you all tapped into Ziggy? You all listen to Ziggy?
No. I only listen to him because he was Maclera.
I also know that song, yeah. I don't know that.
Would you all be willing to listen to him if he rapped in English?
Yeah, for sure. Maybe.
Based on his sound.
Yeah, based on his sound.
Sounds dope. Sounds like those drill type of niggas, yeah.
Pop Smoke, for sure. That's yeah. what he got. That's why that Maclera feature was so, it went so well together, because Maclera same also sound, took a yeah. lot of sauce from Pop Smoke.
Their voices you know? Is complementing yeah. each other, yeah, for sure.
For sure, for yeah. sure. But no, it's crazy. But if Pop Smoke wasn't killed, do you think he would have been leading the wave right now?
Probably be bigger than a lot of niggas that are big now, bro.
For sure, bro.
That guy was eating party music.
But the thing is, he was definitely in the shit, like, you know, like, sure. My favorite song, Paranoia. I'm getting dance in my head. Yeah.
Pop Smoke.
I rock yeah. the party.
I don't even know that song.
Let me play it for you.
Never know it.
Today we're getting copyrighted. Wire.
Paranoia. You don't know it.
It's a dope song. It's super catchy. You know how I first heard of it? They were playing music on YouTube in college, right? And it played next automatically.
For sure.
When I heard it, I'm like, what is this? And I heard, right. Hold on.
Pumping
the
smoke.
Bro, that song. Hold on, I'll play it for you. Maybe you'll know the hook, because I've heard it sampled a lot of times, that paranoia, like on an EDM sure. type of, yeah. But here's the song.
Oh, ooh, Jude back.
That's the one,
yeah.
I'm going to party.
I didn't know it says paranoia.
Yeah.
You didn't know?
Use that,
ooh.
Then
I woo back.
No,
yeah, I know this song.
Shoot that.
So bro could have been going even crazier, you know. But at the same time, I do feel that his death catapulted him as well, probably quicker than he would have if he didn't die, right? Because it's common. It happens, especially in the music industry. When someone dies, we want to know who this person was. We go stream and listen, you know, all that stuff.
All
these
shows, yeah.
And yeah, but speaking of death, and have you all ever heard of a guy called Skrilla?
No, never
okay. You've never heard of Skrilla, Brandon Buckingham.
Now, what do these guys do, bro?
Okay, Brandon Buckingham is a YouTuber. YBC2 is a guy who died, used to be making drill music against these ops. Brandon Buckingham had a song with YBC2, and he had a vlog at YBC2's hood, like a hood vlog. Basically, Brandon Buckingham does those like vlogs where he'll go to Cape Town and hang out with the 26 member, and then they show them around the neighborhood.
How's the place
this
and
that,
things
you know?
Like that, yeah.
So yeah, in he dropped the video, then the next day YBC2, the guy who was showing him, died, got killed by his ops, right? So now it's a thing of, was it just coincidental, or did the video push the people to actually kill him, right? And then weeks later, this Brandon Buckingham guy is with Skrilla somewhere,
the op.
And I don't know if they, I don't think it's the op, no. But he's with Skrilla. I don't know how Skrilla, if Skrilla and YBC2 had something, but either way. And yeah, Skrilla gets, it's alleged that news come out that Skrilla got shot, right? And he was with Brandon Buckingham, right? And Brandon, since the incident of Skrilla getting shot, hasn't said anything on social media. Right, so now people are thinking, is he dead? Is he in critical condition? Is what? Because if he got shot, they literally allegedly got sprayed up, you know. And because Skrilla and him are the two most famous people, that's who they're looking at from there. And Skrilla was reportedly in hospital, yeah, recovering. So him being silent with all this silence, it's getting questionable, right? And now the thing is, it becomes a whole other thing, because when YPC2 died, right?
Yeah.
He basically, when he dissed his ops, he had this whole McDonald's thing because one of his ops died in the McDonald's. Brandon Buckingham. So Brandon is a white guy. Let's get that out there. Brandon is a white guy, right? Mm-hmm. He has a song with YPC2, the guy who died after the vlog dropped. So they did the vlog and they did a song, right? So now people are questioning, is it because of his affiliation with YPC2 that this has just happened to him now, you know? And yeah, it goes to my question of like content, you know?
Yeah.
How far do we go for content?
Now, that's just too crazy, bro. If they really killed him for that, that's just crazy.
I hope he's not dead.
It happens a lot of times,
bro. I hope he's not dead, but karma is a B word at the same time, you know? Because at the end of the day, when what happens is, I need to happen with the naughty, naughty pop, was it when they were dancing of that kid getting stabbed?
Yeah. Right?
Smoking on Tuka in Chicago. These trends that they do on dead people, when you Jing hop on it, the dances, you see who I smoke and all this, you don't actually take a second to think of it. This is someone's child, someone's mother.
It's so indecent.
It's super, bro. Super indecent. Super indecent. And it's what desensitizes the hip-hop audience a lot. You feel?
Yeah, sure.
That's why. Because things are getting more extreme, more extreme, more extreme, more extreme. You know, people are doing that very in graveyards. It's been a thing.
Imagine. Going to a grave with a dead man and digging it up, bruv. Or just doing a music video saying, yeah, you fucked him up. You popped his head and all that and all that. People are gonna come for you for sure.
The thing is now, the trolling is moving also from the music to podcasts, because podcasts are where these artists mostly promote their things, right? So they move the beef from the music to the podcast, and it now becomes different because it's no longer just raps, but it's people doing these little things. My example of that, after Julio Fulio died, right? Y'all remember Julio Fulio, right?
The Fulio guy, yeah.
Young and Ace went on DJ Academics and he had a bottle of Julio, Don Julio, as like a diss to Julio Fulio.
Yeah.
And there's people on YouTube, if you search, who actually break down all the little things you are saying and doing, dissing in the interview, you know?
Yeah.
And you just think to yourself, like, don't these people have introspection? Yoguti, this person died because of this. Because Julio also died because he was dissing, he was doing these things as well. So it's like, you see this person died because of this and you're still going to do the exact same thing. Like, where's the growth in society? You know, like, when is the cycle going to stop, you know? And it's truly sad. It's truly sad to see, you know. It's truly sad. But I just hope that, because South Africans, we like to adopt American trends.
Yeah,
you
sure.
know? I hope it never gets to that point that, you know, now we are going to Avatone. Is it Avatone?
Avatone.
videos at Avatone. Yeah, sure. Imagine me, because I do shoot videos, but yeah, I mean, if you paid me, okay, I would shoot your video at a cemetery, even though it would be creepy, bro. Not gonna lie to you, it would be creepy, but no, I don't think I would, actually. I'd be too scared, bro. I'd be way too scared. Firstly, bro, think about it. If you're gonna shoot, when you shoot a video, right, you move around the space, right?
Sure.
So when you move around the space, there's people's graves. You know, cemeteries, they have like a young line.
Yeah,
you can't just... So that means you'll be shooting, moving around, stepping on people's graves, bro. And that's my worst thing, bro. Like, one of my worst fears is stepping on people's graves, bro. Because, yeah, no, it's... Ah, no, bro. It's strangers on top of that, man. I mean, I don't know what y'all put in your grandfather's graves that now I'll be stepping on. And next thing, my legs... No, South Africans... Be careful, bro. But how long about do y'all believe in witchcraft, though? You have to if you're in South Africa. If you don't...
it's something that's there, whether you believe or you don't.
You don't.
Yeah.
Yeah. What are some extreme cases y'all have heard of or seen of witchcraft?
I've seen some video on TikTok. This other guy, like, he was a goat. Half, like, from his legs going down, he was a goat. Like, going up, he's human, dog. Hit a tail. That was crazy. Think that was happening in Nigeria or some shit.
They were not burning him.
No. Like, people were asking him, like, hey, what do you do till, like, you got like this?
Ooh, yeah. That means they shot him with the KM.
Yeah,
it means.
Yeah, no, that's crazy, bro.
Bro, that's just crazy.
That's super crazy. And, yeah, it makes you super cautious, eh? It makes you super cautious. And, yeah, man, no. But generally, as people, we should be cautious, especially if you go to places where there's different people, you know. We should just be super cautious, bro, because people, bro, yo, the problem is you can't see an evil heart.
That's true.
That's the problem.
You can't see a witch from how they look.
You can't, bro. You can't. So it's just one of those things that we must be extra vigilant, you know.
Yeah.
And the thing is, also us as people, I was talking about this at the shop yesterday, that we are all fakers, right? All of us in the world are fake.
Why do you say that?
I say because at our lowest moment, no one knows but us and probably God or that one loved one. You know, at your lowest moments, when you're crying, when you what, at your lowest moments, no one knows how you are. No one knows your lowest moment personality, right? But we'll most likely know all your high moments, right? So all of us are fakers like that. It's like when someone asks you, are you okay? We'll all say we're okay, right?
Even though you know.
Yeah, okay. Firstly, to avoid this thing of, oh, why are you not okay? Secondly, if I tell this person I'm not okay, what are they going to do about it? You know, there's different reasons why we just go with the I'm okay thing. You
at
know,
some being point, a faker, it's self-conservation.
Definitely is, you know. So, with that, you know, it's like we must just be super aware, you know, because people can see your highlights and think your life is just highlights.
True.
And start getting jealous from your highlights, thinking that's your regular life, you know. And especially to the women. Because I know the girls are the ones who like posting a lot about this and that and, you know, all these things. And you buy them this, then they next post thing,
about it,
next thing, next thing, you know, it's a thing. And you think, Uguti, everyone will be happy and excited as you for what you got. But some people are looking at it from a different perspective that you've got what I don't. Sure. You know? And I can't steal it from you. I can't rob you. So what's the next best thing to hate on you? And
I can't have it, you'd rather not have it.
I can't have it, no one can. No one can. It's that
that's
type of
pure evil.
That's definitely pure evil, bro. That's pure evil. And but I feel like it's as much crazy evil as it is love as well, right? In certain instances, right? Because I could use it in love, that I love someone so much that they're trying to break up with me. But if I can't have you, no one can.
Yeah, sure. I get that.
You know, it's like, obviously, logically, it's bad, you know. But from a perspective of love, I'm just loving this person, you know. And if I can't have you.
But that's just weird, bro.
Yeah,
that's
it's very weird. It's creepy. You know, it's sometimes I think it's being afraid of rejection at some point. Like the fact that somebody rejects you, you are in love with someone, then somebody rejects you, then you chemicalize them in order for them to be with you.
Yeah, no, that's dumb.
Yeah, that's very dumb. You should accept and move on, sure.
Yeah,
we
no,
understand you love them, but then things
they don't
end.
Feel the same,
And sometimes we have to accept, it has ended. Let him breathe or something.
Bro, the scariest part, some of these things, to undo them, you need the originator who did them. So now imagine, now you're no longer feeling this girl. And you've given her, Kim, and now she's following you all your life, bro. Like, and how then, hard is that,
the
bro?
Originator is vibe.
The originator is gone. Dog. You don't know where the originator is anymore, bro. You're stuck with this problem, bro.
You'll end up killing her.
You will, bro. Because now when you're trying to get a new girl as well, she'll be there as well.
She's new incense for sure.
And you're just like,
Oh, girl, please.
Yeah, no. It's crazy.
Yes, child. You'll end up killing her.
Yeah,
you understand when somebody, when something keeps on dotting on you, bro.
Yeah.
You'll cool, Zaganglani, you know. Hi, man. At some point, bruv, cool. You'll take a Zembe, bro, and cut the head.
And cut the head.
Yes.
Bro.
And you end up in jail. For your own consequence, for your own thing, bro.
Hey, bro.
You're the one who started it. Jeez. And it ends you.
Bro.
I know of this story, you know, when we were talking about content and all that and all that. You know, there's this guy called Mike Twitchell. I read about him, but then it's been years.
Mm.
You know that guy used to film horror movies.
Okay.
He used to film horror movies. So what happened was that I don't know how or what happened, what shaked in his head.
Yeah.
But then the movies he was filming, Doc, he started doing them in person.
Hmm.
So he started going into houses and killing people, literally. He wasn't filming himself, but then that's what he used to film. I don't know what happened.
Maybe the conditioning. What?
But then it was like that.
I think it's the same Joker situation.
He was leaving his content now. Huh?
The same Joker situation.
Yeah, sure. It was going houses to houses. Killing people.
Yeah, I mean, I could see that because growing up, there was this thing of if you always watching ID Extra and those crime murder investigation things, generally you'll start feeling a bit more paranoid because it's what you consume so much that you're gonna always think that anything could happen. Someone, a serial killer could right be outside and those little things. So maybe it's like
your life will be just framed around the corners of whatever you're constantly seeing, right?
Yeah.
It becomes you. Hey, it's bad.
It's super bad, bro. It's super bad because yeah, I could see how that could unfold, especially if you're a person with yes men around you, right? And people with power generally don't. They just, whatever you say goes, if you're that type of person, you could, like, just, people try to tell you, no, don't, you know, then you're just like, no, I'm gonna do me, whatever. Then, yeah, no, but it's scary, bro. It's scary.
It is.
It's super scary, but that's... It's very important for us to strengthen our will as people, right? To strengthen... Hold on. Yeah. Yeah, we've been going. But either way, to strengthen, like, our ability to hold ourselves, to control ourselves, right? One of the best ways to do that is fasting, right? Because not only, like... You just, it's like, it's a discipline thing, right? You have to discipline yourself that I'm not going to touch food from this to this, right? And those times you definitely will not once you put your mind to it, right? And once we can do enough of it, you build that self-discipline. I feel like it's very crucial for us to have it, you know, in society, especially as men, right?
Sure.
Because men, our thingy, a lot of things fuel us, you know. Our desires, they also fuel us, you know. Sure. And we are easily led astray. That's why more guys, like, you know, are more, we know them generally as cheaters over women, right?
Yeah, sure.
The percentage, you know, because we know which gents, it's like self-control is like not that much.
It's lacking,
you know. And that's super important in this day and age, right? Because in this day and age, a lot of things are happening, bro. A lot of things physically and spiritually are happening that we don't even understand, right? And how do we know this? We know this because right now, things are getting exposed from 10, 20 years ago, right?
Sure.
So we have a guarantee, Uguti, there's things right now which are going to get exposed in the future, 20
years
right?
Is coming. Yeah, sure.
And we must just be extra vigilant because you don't want to find yourself with a photo at a dirty party. You know, even though you were there for the party, but you don't want to be in a situation, you know, where things where, like that happen.
When things unfold. When you're things one of unfold, the people that are revealed here, so.
Exactly. With so
pure evidence, yeah.
That's why it's important for us to, like, have self-control, you know?
True.
And, yeah, killing our desires, guys. Killing our... I can't wait to speak to you all about something super important. The thing is, right now, I'm in the journey, right, of understanding more of it. And yeah, but when the time is right, I'll explain it to the people, right? But it's about how your semen is your power. Right?
Yeah, I feel you.
And there's a thing I watch. It says it takes about 5 drops of blood to make 1 drop of semen, right? And we should value it so much because it's life. If you think about it, it's life in a liquid. That's how you
produce.
You feel? Yeah. But it's so valueless to us as guys. It's crazy. But either way, that's a whole nother thing because we've been brainwashed to just believe which is just the woman's womb is the most important thing. You know, yes, it is super important, but without the semen, it's nothing. You feel? Yeah. It's just a womb, you know? So we should, as much as we value the womb, we should value, you know? Semen, yeah. And maybe when we bring value to our semen, then when the kid is born, we can have value to that kid, right? Yeah. And not go buy milk for 25 years or however long people buy milk. You understand? Yeah. You feel? So it's a perspective thing, you know? It could be a perspective thing that we changing a whole generational thing by just a simple thought. You know, of valuing something super small, little,
yeah.
Super little, but yeah, no, it's another I feel concept. You,
yeah, that's for another part.
Yeah,
bro,
no, that's definitely for another part.
Yeah, I feel like you can just start going and going and going for hours, boy.
Bro, it gets like yo, bro. It gets crazy, bro. It gets crazy. Just yeah, no, the world, guys, the world. And we should realize how much connection there is between the spiritual and the physical world, you know? It's like there's so much that we can't comprehend because we can't see it, you know? We can't see it, but there's a lot of these things that happen and we take them lightly as innocent things, but a little innocent thing over a certain period of time becomes a habit. And can be very, very bad, you know. So yeah, it's about just that. Yeah, no. But either way, don't let me bore you with stuff. Yeah, no. Yeah, shout out to Diddy and the baby oil.
Crazy.
Diddy oil.
Some Diddy oil, yeah. No.
Crazy.
But yeah, gents, anything y'all wanna add before we wrap up?
Yeah, mate, last time I forgot my merch. Even today I forgot my merch, but it's okay.
Yeah.
For the brand, yeah, it's finally out. Just get your hoodies, like 500 rands. I'm in red color right now. That's the only color I have. Also, ICU t-shirts, I only have black colors. Yeah, it's like 250. Don't forget to purchase that. NTFL is coming soon, guys.
NTFL is dropping.
NTFL
what's
is
happening,
soon.
With NTFL?
Yeah. I'm going to be honest with you. The distribution company is giving me problems with dropping. I was supposed to drop this last month.
Yeah.
Yeah, like late last month, but yeah. I couldn't drop because Distro doesn't want me to drop. So I'm mentioning names. Yeah, Distro Kid. Okay. I don't want to mention names. I don't know why they don't want me to drop.
Wait, when they give you your feedback, don't they tell you that you must review your artwork or is it the audio?
Like, I don't know what's happening, bro, with that, with my account. So I just want to change, like, the distribution company, you see?
Like, okay, use all it.
Yeah, I guess use it.
Can different. I suggest Quali?
Quali?
Yeah, K-H-W-L... W-A-L-E.
Please type it for me. Please type for me. Then send it to
I'll
me.
Send it get to it. Yeah. Yeah. But it's
Kwale, like Zulu Kwale.
Yeah. Like Zulu Kwale. Kwale. Yeah. Oskido. Is it Oskido? Yeah. I think it's Oskido's
distribution company.
Distribution company. Yeah. It's like $300 a year. Unlimited. You know, it was mostly made for piano artists, but I've used it for a whole year and it's beautiful. I like it. You know.
Yeah.
You're also doing music.
Yeah. I
didn't know.
The craziest part is I've changed my whole style of music, right? So a lot of people who are now getting to know I used to do music, they just have to refer to the older old stuff music, before. Yeah, because there's a whole, it's a whole story, bro. But yeah, I've taken a break. My last song was probably like 9 months ago or something, you know. It's my last music video is probably like 10 months ago. Let me check on my channel right now. 1 year ago, actually, is my last music video. Yeah, so it's been a minute. But Kwale, $300 distributes everywhere. Analytics is not really in-depth, right? But for the fact that you can tap into your Spotify for artists and check that, and then you can also get in your Apple Music for artists. And then also your YouTube, you won't be able to, unless if you have YouTube Studio, linked accounts, whatever. Wait, you are verified on YouTube, right? So you are good, for sure. And then, yeah, but Kwale, bro, and for the fact that it's like South African, and the distro is easy, bro, convenient, sufficient.
And the prices are like reasonable,
Price is reasonable, $300 a year, bro.
That's super cheap.
So super reasonable. But let me type it and send it to you. The first time I heard about it was on MacG when Oskido was there, because he was speaking about how he wants to do this for amapiano artists, so they can easily distribute their stuff, you know. Oh. But they do have other plans on there for like record labels or
depends
on the package. But for one artist, it's 300 per year. So far it was my Before Kwale, I used to be on United Masters, right? And I used to enjoy United Masters. United Masters was actually the first distro company I got like my first music royalties from, which is like $50 that I withdrew, but obviously with the tax, it probably got this side like probably like 30-something, $40-something, not something crazy. For the fact that you just made the music, you uploaded it, and you're getting this
cash money.
It's super beautiful, right? But now the thing is, I say that without telling you, which I probably cashed out like last year when I started making music, uploading music in 2019. You see, so it has all those older stuff,
piling and building there.
But either way, royalties, guys, don't streaming royalties are not money. Streaming royalties,
paying gigs are the ones that make
paying gigs are what
also selling merch.
And yeah,
don't forget to buy my merch, 500 rand.
Definitely go tap in with the merch. Yeah. But yeah, United Masters was super dope. But before that, I think I was on Amuse. Amuse is trash, y'all. Amuse is trash, not gonna lie to you. Well, the free version is trash. I don't know if the paid version is dope. At a certain point as an artist, it's very important for you to invest in your music, you know, monetary wise, you know, not just your time and your writing, and whatever, put in the money, you know, to get certain things established, you know. Yeah. And but they say it's either time or money, right? That's why they say time is money, because it's either you're gonna have the time to write, to make a beat, or you're gonna buy a beat, you know. So you can, they are substitutable, you know, which is where I get my value, right? So generally when I'm about to spend money on something, right, where I ask myself if like the time, if I do this a lot when I have to go somewhere, right, like a long distance. If I have to leave here and go to like Alex Penn, I'd calculate with, okay, for me to walk there, it would probably take me 40 minutes. And to catch a taxi, it would probably catch me 13 rand. Cost me 13 rand and about 10 minutes, you feel? So now I have to think, is the time more valuable than the money, or is the money more valuable than the time? Generally, I have time to walk there, because whenever I think of walking there, I have time on my hands, you know. I used to work that side, so I do see a couple of the gents there who still work there. But during my I used to work for Time Bank,
Oh.
As an ambassador. You know those people who get you to come? Yeah.
That's where I met you the first time. But you didn't know me back then.
I definitely did. Yeah.
And you helped me.
Well, if you're going for that, I'm helping us sign papers. Oh, I get definitely. You. I get
yeah,
you. Get
yeah.
You.
And yeah, no, bro. You see, the craziest thing is, man, I got that a lot, bro. I got that a lot. My craziest parts were people would come in and be like, "You remember me?" And then now I have to be like, "I don't remember you," but you can't say, "I don't remember you" to someone. You know, it's yeah, like, "Yo, mfana, yo, mfana, sengibuyile boy, uyangikhumbula ngithi." How do you say no?
I'm going to be like,
Especially as gents, we always do this. You call them bro
the whole time,
whatever, dog,
3 months,
whatever,
the whole time, I don't know your name,
bro. Yeah. And no, the niggas, we never take the time to actually be like, "I want to investigate and get to understand this nigga's name." You just like, no, you grab it in conversation.
Yeah, sure.
Eventually, when people talk,
it'll slip out. Eventually, yeah, sure. That's what you'll say for sure.
That's true.
And even to the person that you're calling bro, dog, it doesn't matter. It doesn't see something.
No,
there,
bro. Like, it's like,
everything is just right. Hey, bro, skip on, wait.
Yeah, fine, bro. Yeah, even yeah. if the bro knows your name, he's still gonna call you bro.
Sure.
Yeah. Only time they'll call you by your name is if you are far. Oh, and there's something where they seeing you, greeting you.
Sure.
But Jay, if we've been chilling the whole day,
it can't be.
You can't do that.
It doesn't
dog.
Work.
It does. Now the problem is when it comes to it gets complicated because the ladies, they take it a bit more personal. Like, you don't know my name.
You forgot my name.
Most of them, you know, they get it like that, you know, and you. As gents, you're just so used to the gent mentality of, man, it is what it is.
Yeah, sure. You know? I don't know your name, but I still know you. Cool. Let's move on. Yeah, sure.
But they want that personal thing, you know, for you to actually know them.
Get to know them.
It's important for you to know a lady's name, eh?
Super important.
Yeah, and there's, hey, Brian. Yeah.
Have you ever experienced a point where, like, you called a hun with a different name?
Hey, Brian. Hey, bro, that's the worst thing ever. But you know they mice it.
Some
mice it, bro, and ask you after. But who is that? Hey, yeah. But some are sicarios, bro. They were just snapped right there, bro. You call me
right there.
You call me who?
Crazy, bro.
Yeah. It is for sure.
This part has been gone and I'm hungry.
This audio says, I don't know.
So yeah,
we're about to wrap up the episode, né?
Okay.
So what happened? Yeah, audio cut, but it is what it is. You've heard hours and hours and minutes of us speak.
Mm-hmm.
Let's wrap it up, gents. Plug your IGs, anything, yeah. And let us know.
Yo, add Rodeo to the World. On Instagram, that's my first account, R444 World. That's my second account. And then 444 the brand, go follow that account also. Yeah, go follow Neighbors World.
I'm only 65 Tyler on Instagram and Facebook, I'm Tyler D.
Mm. I made a
mess.
That's
it.
I'm spilling snakes everywhere. Mm. But yeah, for me, click this video on your screen. Yeah. Everyone always looks for the video. But it's gonna show up on YouTube. But yeah, shout out.